You're watching footage of Portland, Oregon Mayor Ted Wheeler in our national lead. He was tear gassed last night by federal officers. This happened just hours after President Trump announced he is sending hundreds more federal agents into, in his words, quote, Democrat-run cities, unquote, facing rising crime. The Portland mayor later told reporters that he saw nothing that provoked or justified the response of tear gas. Now the Justice Department's independent watchdog is investigating the use of force used by federal officials in Portland and in Washington, D.C. last month, as senior members of previous Republican administrations are speaking up and protesting what the president is doing, including our next guest, Michael Chertoff, the former Homeland Security Secretary under President George W. Bush. Secretary Chertoff, thanks so much for joining us. You've called this move of the president to send agents into cities very problematic and unsettling. Why? Why do you think it's damaging for the Department of Homeland Security?
Well, I was particularly focused on the issue of using agents for crowd control. It's appropriate to protect federal buildings, but it looks, based on the reporting in the video, as if the Homeland Security agents who were sent in ranged somewhat outside the perimeter of the federal building, that they were dressed in a way more appropriate to, you know, quasi-combat operations on the southern border than an urban environment, and that there was no coordination or cooperation with local authorities. And that really oversteps, I think, what the federal authorities are, and is certainly unwise in terms of the way they executed and may actually have poured gasoline onto the fire, so to speak.
And this initially started with them, these agents being unidentified, driving around Portland in vans and snatching up people, and nobody knew what was going on. It was all very mysterious. Another former Homeland Security Secretary, your predecessor, Tom Ridge, said something on CNN last night that I want to get your reaction to.
Well, I'm disappointed in my president because it seems like it's a reality TV approach toward dealing with a very, very serious problem.
Secretary Ridge also went on to say in a radio interview that the Department of Homeland Security was not established to be the president's personal militia. Personal militia is pretty harsh. Do you have that view as well, that that's how Trump is using it?
Well, I think certainly the way the White House announced this, by focusing on the fact that it's Democratic mayors and tying this into some campaign advertisements, certainly lends the strong impression that the White House views this as a political stunt. And, you know, we worked very hard, Tom Ridge and I and our successors also, both the Bush and Obama administrations, to make DHS nonpartisan, treat everybody as if they're part of the same team as the Defense Department does. And so I kind of in the same boat as General Milley and Secretary Esper, when they reacted to Lafayette Square in saying this is not appropriate, our obligation is to the Constitution. And that ought to apply to DHS as well.
But it's interesting that you bring that up, because it was very clear like a month or so ago that President Trump wanted the U.S. military to go into cities, and then Milley and General Milley and Secretary Esper balked at that. They didn't want that. And now he's doing this, and it seems like it's the same basic plan. Oh, okay, I can't get the military. I'll just use the Department of Homeland Security. This is what people feared the Department of Homeland Security was going to be back when it was formed during the Bush administration. And now they're seeing their fears realized in some ways, don't you think?
Well, I think in this case, by taking people from the Border Patrol, who should be at the border, by the way, and using them as crowd control actors, is abusing, and we've seen, frankly, abuse of other departments. I mean, sometimes the Department of Justice has done things that make people wonder what happened to the norms that, you know, professional prosecutors used to abide by. The good news is, I think, as you saw with the military, that ultimately these are resilient organizations. The people who make up the rank and file of DHS, I think, want the department to function the way it's supposed to, protecting Americans in a nonpartisan, constitutional way.
President Trump attacked Tom Ridge as a never-Trumper and a Republican in name only, a rhino, said that he was squirming, although I'm guessing that former Vietnam veteran Staff Sergeant Ridge wasn't squirming much. Do you worry Trump is going to go after you next?
Badge of honor.
The cities that President Trump is sending more troops to, Chicago, Albuquerque, Kansas City, it is true that they have seen an increase in crime. Chicago saw 34% more homicides than last year. Albuquerque's violent crime rate is more than three times the national average. Kansas City is on track to record its most homicides ever. What tools can the president use to stop this? What should he be doing differently?
Okay, so what they're talking about doing in Chicago, at least as reported by the Attorney General, is different than the crowd control issue, which I'm troubled by in Portland. What they're talking about doing in Chicago is sending investigators and prosecutors in to focus on violent drug gangs and other kinds of violent gun smugglers and actors. That is something actually that the U.S. government has done for many years. I did it when I was U.S. Attorney in New Jersey, because there are specific federal laws against smuggling guns and using them to commit felonies. And that means that the government has a right and a duty, in fact, to investigate and prosecute those who do it. So as long as the mission in Chicago is what Attorney General Barr declared it would be, it's perfectly appropriate. And I think the mayor would welcome that. What should not happen is to have it migrate over into dealing with demonstrations and crowds.
All right, former Department of Homeland Security Secretary Michael Chertoff from the George W. Bush administration. Thank you so much. Good to see you again, sir.
Good to see you too, Jake.